Hey, everybody. Welcome to Brilliant Frugal Living. Shout outs from everybody here in Studio B as we connect with our 200 plus stations coast to coast. Greetings to you all. This week's show is brought to you by our caring sponsors at Elite Rehab, because everyone knows a family that's fighting the effects of today's substance abuse epidemic. And if someone you care about needs help, helps out there, pick up the phone and call the professionals at 800-932-4082. That's 800-932-4082. Help the ones you care about put that chapter behind them. 800-932-4082. Could not wait to talk about this next subject. This was sent to me. I love this. This is a couple in the Midwest. I believe it's Michigan. Where did I get this from? Sean Carter. I love this. Sending me this story. Quentin and Michelle Ross. They're a young couple. They had about, what do they have, $120,000 in student debt. Now, a lot of us have debt in all kinds of forms. Student debt, credit card debt, real estate debt, investment debt, who knows, whatever kind of debt. Debt is debt. It's chaining you to someone else. You're going to work in the morning to pay off them, not to pay off your life, but to pay off debts to them. So there you go. And their student loans, this wonderful couple, Quentin and Michelle Ross, their student loans came up to 120 grand, which is about 3.5 times, I believe, the national average for college grads in their 30s, and 5 times that of grads in their 20s. But they wanted to pay it off. This couple's originally from Detroit, decided to stay local for school. Quentin, who is now 33, so handsome, double majored in telecommunications and criminal justice at Michigan State. God bless. I went to Penn State, barely squeaked through with one degree. So you got to love that. Marshall, 28 years old, took up secondary education at the University of Detroit. All right. So these are some solid majors. Now, when these guys graduated in 2008, 2016 for Marshall, 2008 for Quentin, his loans were 40 grand. All right. That was 10 years ago. Marshall graduated in 2016. Her loans were about 80 grand. So together they owed roughly about 120. And while they both received scholarships in high school that went towards their college, it didn't make much of a dent in the debt. So they're talking and they said they never really heard about people paying off their student loans so much. And that same thing goes with all debt. Name one person you know out there, guys, that has no debt. It's become this understood, accepted, I say biting my cheek, accepted thing to have huge amounts of debt. You guys see all of these banks being built on every corner in America, and we wonder, how can they afford to build all these things? How does this work? How does it work? Because everybody out there is working so hard, and they've got tons of debt, and they're only paying the interest on them. These banks are flooded with interest money every day. Perfectly legal, perfectly square. We all signed up for these kind of debts, but that's how they're making their money. Nobody's paying off their principal. Certainly nobody's thinking about paying off their debt in record time. And these two decided to completely flip that switch, to flip that business model. They'd never really heard about people paying off their student loans too much. You know, Quentin's talking about how his mom had loans for like 20 years after she graduated. And that's a lot of us out there. When I graduated from college in the early 90s, I had maybe 10 grand in debt. I still had that when I got married 5 years later. And I was so panicky at the thought of bringing any student debt into my marriage that we just knocked it out first thing. I only had like 2 grand left on my student loans. And I was a panic attack. Now, these days, people have 100 grand and it's considered normal. It's not. It is a shackle around your ankle. It's keeping you from buying a home that you want. It's keeping you from investing the way you want to. It's keeping you from buying a car with cash and then saving yourself huge money that way. It's keeping you from all of the things that you could be doing with that money right now to leapfrog above everybody else when it comes to investments in the future. Paying off your debt should be job number one. When you come home from a hard day's work, do you want to say you worked for yourself to pay off your house a bit more, to, you know, pay for your cars with cash, to buy the things you love with cash? Or do you want to say, I just worked a 12-hour day and it's all going to credit card interest? How demoralizing is that? Let's flip that business model on its head. So this wonderful, beautiful, amazing couple gets married in 2015. Just a few years ago, decide to try to beat the odds. And they said, I love this quote, it all boiled down to freedom. He didn't want to work his entire life and always have to pay bills to other people for interest on things bought decades ago. And all of so many people I know, the hardworking people that write me, that email me, that text me, get a hold of me on Facebook, it's all the same stuff. You deserve freedom from your debt. And that was their driving force. It wasn't just the debt. It was a bigger factor for them. And Marshall's saying this, talked about a lot of very serious things in their relationship. They were on the same page. They're thinking about starting a family in the not too distant future, they say, which is wonderful stuff. And they had the bold, brilliant, lightning bolt insight that they didn't want to have this 120 grand in debt holding over their heads when they decided to start a family. That is brilliant. Now, did they pay this all off at once, you know, from the beginning? No. They had always paid the minimum balance because they were conscious of maintaining good credit. There's a good message there, but however, look underneath the message. When the banks say, make sure you pay your minimums each month, your credit score is going to be so much better because of it, great, but finish the sentence. When you only pay the minimum on any loan, whether it's a credit card or a student loan or a car loan or your home, you are paying so much more money to these entities over the life of that loan. If you bought a $200,000 house, you are paying back easily $600,000 over the life of the loan. Same thing goes for cars. Same thing goes for student loans. Same thing goes for credit cards. Just to the umpteenth power, the interest rates on credit cards, you spend $100 on an average credit card, and it's going to depend on your interest rate, but you could easily be paying back $500 when all is said and done. It's insane. So I love this. So they put together a plan. They decided to lean on some reliable mentors they met during school. They read all the financial expert stuff. I was delighted. Changed their mentality on how paying the debt was possible. And they implement this genius method called the snowball method. You pay your smallest loan first in its entirety. Cut up that credit card, you know, shred that paperwork that says you still owe money. Then you move on and you put that same amount of money plus some onto the next largest, okay? Now, this is something, I love this. I'm also in voiceover work a little bit, and a very prominent voiceover artist named Red Horrocks, a hysterical lady, did the exact same thing, it's mentioned here, paid off 40 grand in debt in 5 years on a very low salary. Same thing. So with the first check of the month for Quentin, he would make sure they had money for the mortgage. Boom, that's done. The utilities, everything else, gas for the car, and then with the second check of the month, you put toward whatever loan you're focusing on at that time. Does that sound like something you can do? I say that rolling my eyes because everybody can do it. You've got money in the bank, or you want to have more money in the bank. You've got money coming in. This economy is white hot. You're exhausted. You're grateful for the work. You love all the extra hours because that means you've got extra money coming in. How are you putting that money to its highest and best use to free you from debt down the road? Are you getting sucked into that mentality, into that thinking that, you know what, I work hard. I'm going out to dinner tonight with my friends. We're going to get a couple of cocktails, do everything else, and you're spending $200 on dinner. No. Or would you rather have that $200 go towards debt so that you're not in debt next year, the year after, everything else? And when you are, oh, this is a beautiful day. When you are out of debt, that unthinkable, unimaginable day in your future when you are out of debt, you've got no credit card debt, no car debt, no student debt, no mortgage, and money in the bank, that's when you're going to be going out and having a lot of fun with friends. I cannot begin to tell you the different mindset and the way your body will feel when you get up in the morning and you have no debt. You're getting up to work in the morning to put the money in the bank for your future. Not the banker's future, not the car loan guy's future, not even the restaurant owner's future. You're going to be doing that later on. Of course, you're still going to be enjoying yourself once in a while, but you'll be doing it with a bigger goal in mind. You'll be doing it with the goal of being able to do whatever you want in a fully paid off house, driving around a fully paid off car, looking at balances for a beautifully funded retirement coming up, your kids' college are paid for, or however you want to handle that with your kids. It is a feeling unlike anything. And I use this analogy a lot. Nutritionists out there like to say, if they could get everybody out there with a little extra weight to walk around one day in a body in perfect shape, it would be so motivating that they would immediately switch up their mindset and do everything they needed to make it a reality. I say the same thing with personal finance. If everybody out there exhausted, I hear from you, the circles under your eyes, you're getting no sleep, you feel like you got no time with your family, you're working like crazy. What would happen if all of that work was translated into a lifestyle where sooner than you think, all of your debt is paid off? That's what I'm talking about. That's some brilliant frugal living. This couple did it. You can do it as well. Pick the debt. Make it happen. You are the captain of your destiny. Guys, the time is flying. I'm getting a huge wrap-up signal here. More after this.